So we've been using this word network so far. And what is a network? So we usually call networks our areas of the program inside of our Touch Designer kind of environment. So this might be our network, but what we'll see soon is that you can have many different networks inside of Touch Designer because of the way you can kind of encapsulate certain functionality and kind of the pseudo 3D aspect of the hierarchy of a Touch Designer kind of application. So this would be considered a network. There's no reason it's not considered a network. It's a bunch of operators inside of Touch Designer doing a piece of functionality. And generally, what we do is this whole area here, where you see is kind of the main part of our screen, that's called our network editor, which is different than, at the bottom we have a timeline, and at the top we kind of have menus. Inside of this pane is our network editor. And this is where we're working on creating operators, building our functionality, and doing whatever else we want to do inside of Touch Designer. Now, all areas of the network have different paths. And these paths are very similar to how paths might work for files and folders on your computer. So the path structure that we have inside of Touch Designer is actually most similar to Linux or Unix-based kind of operating systems. And you can see right here, we have what's called our path bar. And this shows us the path to the network that we're inside of right now. So we'll talk about more how to get around the different network, but it's important to note that once we start encapsulating different things, we'll start looking at the network and we'll especially start paying attention to the path here. And like I said, it's most similar to a Linux or Unix environment where, it starts with a forward slash and then you have, for instance, project one. That's the name of the area of the network I'm in. I could go inside something like this GO1 and then it would be slash project one slash GO1. So it's exactly like a folder and file structure where kind of the operators are our files and containers and other components that we can put stuff inside of become our folders. So with that said, let's look at navigating the network a little bit and exploring these paths. So like I just said, right now we are at forward slash project one forward slash. That means we are inside of a component named, Project One. So what I can see here is that if I turn off this little plus button, there are operators that all have different colors, and those colors are associated with families. But the gray edged operators are important in this case because they kind of act as our folders. So for example, what I could do is I could double click on this, operator named GO1, and then all of a sudden, you can see my path bar has changed to be forward slash project one slash GO1. And I have a totally new area of the network, which has operators I wasn't seeing before, because now we are inside a different network of our kind of Touch Designer application. And just like I was saying with that folder and file, hierarchy that's similar to Linux or Windows or Mac OS, this GO1 component had other components inside of it. Now, what you'll notice is that if you try and do this on all the operators, nothing happens. If I'm trying to double click on these different operators, nothing happens. It's because only those gray operators, like I mentioned, and we'll go up a level in a moment to talk about that, can hold other operators inside of them. So we saw that double clicking was a way to go into an operator. Now, what we can do is there's multiple different ways to get up. Now, one that I never use, but you should know about because just in case it happens and you're kind of curious what's going on, you can use the mouse wheel to just start scrolling backwards out of a network. And when you get far enough, all of a sudden, you'll kind of leave that area of the network you are. Now you saw we're back in our familiar kind of starting template. We see the path is now slash project one slash. So you can use the scroll wheel to also go into a network. So if you just keep zooming in on it, eventually you'll land in it. And similarly, scrolling out gets you out of it. But I really don't recommend this for most users because A, it's slow compared to the keyboard shortcuts I'm about to show you. And B, it just takes too long. I mean, it really just is slow. It's not as accurate. So the keyboard shortcuts that we're going to use are firstly, I to go inside of a network. That's how you make it easier to remember. I to go in. So when I hit I with that operator selected, I go inside of it. And U to go up a level. So I hit U, I jump up a level. I hit I jump in a level. I hit U, I jump back out. And you can notice that We're still inside of something called Project One. So let's hit U and take a look at what we have here. So you can see if we hit U, now we're at forward slash, which on kind of Linux systems is your root. And this is what we call the root of our network. We have one gray operator here, like we said, which can hold other operators. We've got a few more here called perform and local. 99.999% of the time, you should just ignore perform and local on root. And you should always just work inside of your own kind of container where you could put your functionality. So, like I said, I goes inside of a network. You can see every time we hit it, U goes out of a network. It goes up one level. And then one other very useful thing is H. The H key does something called home. It homes your network and basically fits all the operators inside of that network onto the available screen real estate. So for example, if I was to drag this operator really far away and I was working in here and I didn't know, you know, where did that operator go? I could hit H, and what it would do is find the boundaries of all of the operators inside of that network and resize the whole thing and center it onto my screen. So with a combination of using something like the I key to go into networks, H to kind of just home them really quickly to the center of your screen, U to go outside of them, you can really quickly and easily move around the network in much faster way than it would be to do kind of this zoom in and out with your mouse wheel and like wait for animations to complete. You know, the I and the U method and using the home are the much, much, much more preferred way to go about network navigation. So with that said, let's keep looking at some other elements of Touch Designer.